Hello everyone, this is the second video on nucleic acid chemistry, and at the end of this video you should be able to describe in detail the structure of DNA, types of DNA and properties of DNA. Before going further, let's take a look at historical background. The double helical structure of DNA was first proposed by James Watson and Francis Crick. They shared Nobel Prize with Maurice Wilkins in 1962. But sadly, the contribution of Rosalind Franklin towards unraveling structure of DNA was not acknowledged. Rosalind Franklin was an English chemist and X-ray crystallographer. Her X-ray diffraction studies eventually facilitated the discovery of double helix structure of DNA. As her contribution was ignored, she is referred to as Dark Lady of DNA. DNA is a polymer of repeating subunits called deoxyribonucleotides. It has four types of deoxyribonucleotides. First one is 2' deoxyadenosine monophosphate. Second is 2' deoxyguanosine monophosphate. Third is 2' deoxycitidine monophosphate. And the fourth is 2' deoxythymidine monophosphate. Nucleotides are joined to one another by 3', 5' phosphodiester bonds, and this bond is formed between 3' carbon of one nucleotide and 5' carbon of other nucleotide. 5' end here means the terminal residue whose C5 is not linked to other nucleotide, and 3' end means the terminal residue whose 3' is means carbon 3' is not linked to another nucleotide. Now let's study in detail the Watson and Crick model of DNA. Double helix structure of DNA is right-handed and it has two anti-parallel strands, means one strand runs in 3' to 5' direction and other runs in 5' to 3' direction. It means that both strands run in opposite direction and both strands are complementary to each other. A pairs with T, that is adenine pairs with thymine and guanine pairs with cytosine. Thus, the base sequence of one strand defines base sequence of other strand, and because of this specific base pairing, the amount of A equals to T and amount of G equals to C. It means that total purines equal to total pyrimidines. And this complementary base pairing proves Chargaff rule. Chargaff's rule states that DNA from different species have different base composition. DNA base composition of different tissues in the same organism is same. Age, nutrition and environment have no effect on DNA base composition, and the principle of base equivalence, which states purines are equal to pyrimidines. Two strands are held together by hydrogen bonds, which are developed between purines and pyrimidine bases of opposite strands. Adenine always bonds with thymine by two hydrogen bonds, and guanine always bonds with cytosine by three hydrogen bonds. Why purine pair with pyrimidine and vice versa? It is because of the reason that space in the core of DNA molecule is just sufficient to allow purine-pyrimidine pair, and the second reason is steric hindrance by the anti-configuration of N-glycosidic bonds favor only AT and GC pairing. Imagine what would happen if purine pairs with purine and pyrimidine pairs with pyrimidine. So if purine pairs with purine, they would not fit into the space available, and if two pyrimidine form a pair, they would be too far apart to form hydrogen bonds. And that's why purine pairs with pyrimidine always. In the DNA structure, because of the hydrophobic nature of nitrogenous bases, the bases are stacked inside, and the deoxyribose and phosphate groups, which is called a sugar backbone, they are hydrophilic in nature and they are present on the outside of the double helix. Coiling of two strands create a major groove and a minor groove on the surface of double helix. Proteins interact with DNA at these grooves without disrupting the double helix. In the Watson-Crick model of DNA, each pair of the bases is placed at distance of 3.4 armstrong unit, and there are about 10 base pairs per complete turn of helix. So that each turn of helix is 3.4 nanometer, that is 34 armstrong unit, and the width of double helix is 20 armstrong, that is 2 nanometer. Both strands of DNA can act as sense and antisense strands. So let's see what does it mean by sense and antisense strands. Template strand is also called as antisense strand, and it is a strand that is transcribed or copied into the RNA molecule, and the other strand is called sense or coding strand. But it is noteworthy that each strand of DNA can act as a template strand for the synthesis of its complementary strand. Hence, the hereditary information is coded in the sequence of bases of either strand. Now, let's compare the structural features of various types of DNA, that is ADNA, BDNA and ZDNA. Helix turn of ADNA and BDNA are right-handed, while in case of ZDNA, it is left-handed. The helical diameter in ADNA is 26 armstrong, in BDNA it is 20 armstrong, and in ZDNA it is 18 armstrong. The height of the helical turn in ADNA is 28.6 armstrong, in the BDNA it is 24 armstrong, while it is 44 armstrong in ZDNA. The number of bases per helical turn in ADNA are 11.6. And the number of base pairs are 10 in BDNA, while in ZDNA they are 12 in numbers. The distance between each base pair in ADNA is 2.9 armstrong, while in case of BDNA it is 3.4 armstrong, and in case of ZDNA it is 7.4 armstrong. The tilt of base pair relative to the helical axis is 20 degree in ADNA. It is 6 degree in BDNA and it is 7 degree in ZDNA. The major groove in ADNA is narrow and deep, while in case of BDNA it is wide and deep, and in case of ZDNA it is a flat. The minor groove in ADNA is wide and shallow, while in case of BDNA and ZDNA the minor groove is narrow and deep. Now let's learn about the properties of DNA, that is denaturation, renaturation, hyperchromicity, decreased viscosity and DNA hybridization. The first property of DNA is denaturation. It is the unwinding and separation of two strands of DNA, and it occurs due to heat or denaturing agents. In this case, covalent bonds are not broken. Only weak bonds like hydrogen bonds, electrostatic bonds and hydrophobic interactions are broken. The separated strands of DNA on cooling undergoes renaturation, which is also called as annealing. Here the reassociation of separated strand occur to form again the double-stranded DNA structure. This denaturation and renaturation property of DNA is useful in polymerase chain reactions. Third property is hyperchromicity. The denatured DNA shows increased absorption of light at 260 nanometer. In the separated strands, purine and pyrimidine bases are exposed to more light, and this property is used to estimate the purity of DNA. The next property is decreased viscosity. It occurs due to separated strands which are more flexible than the rigid rod-like double-stranded DNA structure. What is melting temperature of DNA? It is the temperature at which half of the DNA undergoes denaturation. Melting temperature depends on concentration of guanine and cytosine. If guanine and cytosine concentration or content is high, the melting temperature is high, and it is because of the presence of three hydrogen bonds between guanine and cytosine, so it requires more temperature or more heat to disrupt these three hydrogen bonds. The next property of DNA is DNA hybridization. It is the base pairing of two complementary DNA strands from two different species to form a duplex DNA. In the next video, we will study how in a cell, extraordinary degree of organization is required to pack 2 meters long DNA in a tiny nucleus of 10 micrometer size. Till then, have a great time. Happy learning and thank you for watching.